Today's topic of discussion is surgical techniques to treat recurrent dislocation of the shoulder. Hi everyone, I am Dr. Lalit Bafna. I am an arthroscopy and joint replacement surgeon currently working in SCI International Hospital, GK1. We should get an X-ray and MRI and CT scan based on which we should calculate the glenoid bone defect, glenoid tract, defect and Hill-Sachs index. And we should quantify defect, whether the defect is on track or off track. That means bony defect is within the content glenoid lesion or whether it is out of glenoid lesion. Doctor can offer two types of the surgeries, either arthroscopic surgery or open surgery. In arthroscopic surgeries, what we called as the arthroscopic Bankart repair, in which we repair the Bankart tear into its original or native position on glenoid with the help of suture anchors. Sometimes if Hill-Sachs defect is bigger in size, then we can address Hill-Sachs defect by doing something called a remplissage procedure, which we do an arthroscopic technique in which the rotator cuff muscle, that is infraspinatus muscle, we will use to feel the Hill-Sachs defect, by the virtue of which Hill-Sachs defect become exteriorized to the native glenohumeral joint. These are the two surgical techniques which we can do in arthroscopic way, which is indicated especially in a few dislocations and if the labrum is of good quality and if defect is on track. Sometimes due to multiple recurrent dislocations of the shoulder, if glenoid loss is more than 25%, along with that if there is a bigger Hill-Sachs defect, then arthroscopic procedures are not possible or there is high chance of failure through arthroscopic procedure, where we can offer a glenoid augmentation procedure in which we augment glenoid with the help of coracoid and its attached soft tissue muscles. We called it as a Letarget procedure. It is one of the highly successful procedure. In certain situations, Letarget procedure is not possible, especially in the revision cases, revision Letarget cases, or if there is a coracoid fracture, or if there is something called epileptic patients where there is a chances of high voluntary contraction of the muscle, we do a glenoid augmentation with the help of iliac crest bone graft. That is, we call as the Eden hibernate procedure. So these are the four important procedures which are there for treating recurrent dislocation of the shoulder. The most common complication following surgery is the advantage of these procedures. Highly successful procedure, but the disadvantage or complications like infection, bleeding, along with that, there is a chances of redislocation despite doing the best surgery, and it because of laxity of the connective tissue or the soft tissue around the shoulder joint. Sometimes there is a chance of iatrogenic damage to the axillary nerve, even both arthroscopic and in the open procedure. And there is some, it might lead to some stiffness if patient do not follow a proper rehabilitation program. Thank you.